What's the opening?
Oh yeah, hello YouTubers.
Yeah, hello YouTubers.
Today we're going to talk about three things because we were asked about what camera we got. So we're going to talk about the camera. We're going to talk about the microphone.
Do that.
And we're going to talk about the SteadyCam.
Okay. The reason we're getting a new camera is because the old one, when we go out and we be filming someplace and you're going like this, everybody tend to laugh at us. So that's why we got the new camera.
He kept going like this. I kept going, why do you keep going like this? I don't know why he keeps going like that.
Okay.
But we needed better audio.
Oh, we did.
Yes.
Because this was, can you hear me
now?
Now,
I can't hear you.
I can hear you. You're right next to me.
Oh, that's why. But technically, this is supposed to be taught.
It's supposed to be very tight.
Taught.
Yeah. Then you get excellent reception.
Can you hear me now better?
Okay.
Talk full, and that's, is it.
Okay, what are we doing next? Takes a mini DVD tapes.
Yeah, let me tell you what kind of camera it is. A Panasonic, what is it again? It's a Panasonic PVGS500. And I did about 2 weeks research on this thing, and I'm telling you, I spent way too many hours, but I'm happy, and I decided to get this one for us. And it takes mini DVDs, mini DVDs, goes right in there like that, and shuts like that. The couple things that I liked about it was it takes photos, so you can put it on photos.
And still photos.
Still photos, and it also has a built-in flash.
That way, if you want to go like that, this will take it.
Watch. I'm going to show you how to take a photo and use Gene has the subject. It's a very important thing to have Gene has the subject just so I can, got to take the thing off there.
That's important.
I'll show you this later. Okay, now, I told you about the built-in flash. Work. I had the built-in flash turned off, which reminds me, it's got a really neat little menu right here that you can go up and down. It's got a little joystick, and you can go left and right, and
you see the menu.
Turn the flash on.
Spaghetti, spaghetti and meatballs, $7.99.
Oh, I want some of that.
That's a very good menu.
That's a good menu. All right, let me try this again. I stepped on. Sorry, dog. Okay, ready? Flash. That was a funny picture. One more smile. Dog on me.
Yeah.
Doggy. Oh, he's so cute. Oh, he's so cute. Okay. That's so much taking a photo. I'll show you those photos. Dog jumping on us.
He's jumping on my...
It's got built-in flash. Of course, this LCD is pretty big, and it turns towards you. And... one of the things I like about this is that at night, or if it's a little dark, you can actually turn this on if you know what it's called, and it's like a little flashlight. It produces a little light to make it so it's not so dark.
Okay. This has a zoom, zoom, zoom.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. It zooms in. It's got a 10-time zoom. That's a 10-times optical zoom. But I'm going to show you a little thing I took. It also goes... 700 digital zoom. And I'm going, wow, how can I go 700? Well, I went down the alley and I zoomed in clear down the opposite street when Gene was going for a walk. I'll show you that video. You'll probably see it right this very minute. Because you know, Gene, he doesn't like always walk real steady.
Yeah, I'm a little rickety when I walk, so
he's a little rickety. So they keep you from But you know what? Yeah. These things are so light. When I was doing the swap meet, it was.
I
really
used to
bouncy.
Duct tape it to my neck, but it got uncomfortable. So this is much better.
Yeah. Yeah, you could duct tape it like all around there. Yeah. It's so small. I couldn't believe how small it is. Let's see, what else do we want to talk about? Oh, you know, some of these don't have earphones. This one doesn't have earphones, although you can rig it up so you can have an earphone in there, so when you play back, you can hear things back. But it does have a little speaker, and I didn't know that when I bought it. I thought that was pretty nice.
Can you play that?
You can play back, and it has like a little speaker in there.
There's
so
a little man in there going, and now we're going to tell you about this.
And he sounds just like that, too. Oh, and it's got a little viewfinder here that comes in and out. Or you can use the LCD, which is nice. And the menu's all in there. The thing I liked about it, and I'm going to zoom in and take some cutaways, because I know about cutaways, that you've got like a little toggle right here, which is really nice, and not the on-screen menu, which I was looking at that one also. We went and ordered some other batteries. It comes with a battery. Little battery, we got a couple bigger batteries. We got the cheap ones, which were just as good as the expensive ones, we found out. Any questions?
What's the next accessories? What's that?
Accessories that come with it.
You already explained that.
No, I haven't.
Oh, okay.
Shall I do that now?
Yeah, do that now.
Okay. I don't think he's paying attention.
I think I was dozing.
You know, Zipster's got that Zoom where he can lay over there and sit on the couch and zoom in and out. Well, we can do that too. Of course, I don't have that. I'm using an EyeSight for the Macintosh, an EyeSight right now. And also, I want you to notice the sound. Listen to the sound compared to what you're going to be hearing when I tell you about the microphone. Anyway, the accessories for the camera is a Zoom and a remote control. Another one is that you can plug it in, have it on the tripod and do a photo or zoom in or out or push record and it works. And then you can plug it in video out with that thingy.
You know, it's so much different than when in the old days when you were sitting in front of the TV, what you'd do is you'd wait for somebody to go by and then you'd have them, would you put it on channel 11? And that was our remote control.
We call those our kids. Why we had kids? Just so they would run over there and change the channel for us.
They were just walking by.
Walking by. Yeah. Even if they weren't walking by, we'd call them in and say, we need channel 7 turn. Of course, there was only 3 channels in our day.
What's a shotgun mic? Is that for a wedding or what?
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's enough about the camera, but I'll give you a website that will tell you way more. And then I joined a forum, which I can't remember right now, but I'll tell you the name of the forum, which I really, really helped me make some decisions. And I wanted to see the quality of the video was really nice. So everything turned out that's the one I picked after weeks and weeks of looking. Now we'll talk about the shotgun mic, because I do need this back. One of the things I found out after recording is that the speaker in this camera, I mean the mic in the camera, I think it's like an omnidirectional mic that picks up all kinds of noise. You know, when we went to the swap meet, if I hadn't have used this new microphone, this shotgun mic, it would have just picked up all the sounds all around instead of zooming in on Gene and that other old guy with the gray beard. Yeah. Was zooming in on their speech and all their sounds. So
it drowns out the outside noise.
It drowns out any noise on the side of it. That's it's great. Called a Rode video mic. And it's got a little on-off switch, got a little battery in here. It's kind of neat how it plugs into the camera. It kind of is loose like that. It goes in the side here and then
it just snaps on the top.
You pull this back and then it just snaps on the top like this. And it looks a little big. But this was really what let us capture some of the sound that you heard on that swap meet. Mm-hmm. So these go on all kinds of cams as long as you have a shoe.
Why is it flopping back and forth like that?
Well, I'm not really sure, but I think it's to keep it from, I don't know. Oh, I know why. It's to keep it from hearing the motor noise in the camera.
Is that right?
Yeah.
That's a good question.
But it's really a professional one. The people that make this Rode, that make this camera or make this microphone, they make really, really expensive ones. But this one was $149, and it just improves the sound so much.
But what's a you got a dead cat there? It sounds like my my lawn mowing days.
This is a dead cat. The dead cat fits over. Well, you could use it to just kind of. It kind of looks like his beard, don't it?
It'd kind of be good in the back, like
Like back there. You can hang it from your hat.
Yeah, hang it from the hat.
So,
yeah. Or you could use it on the microphone.
Or we could put it on the dog's tail.
Yeah.
Be imitating a cat, sort of. What it does is it goes on the microphone like this. And I know that Perry Urban was out for a walk one day, and it was really windy over there in Scotland, and all you could hear was the wind. But I think I heard him in the background a little bit. It wasn't too bad. But Perry Urban had a dead cat and a microphone like this. I don't know if you still could hear him because it would be...
You wouldn't hear him.
No, you could still hear him.
You wouldn't hear
you'd
the
have
outside
to point
noise.
The, he'd be pointing the camera at him.
Yeah.
At himself.
Yeah,
so
the outside noise was
but there
gone.
Would be all the wind. You wouldn't hear any of that wind noise.
Yeah.
Which we haven't actually tried it, but it does make a lot of sense. So it's got this one. Oh, I wonder if that goes on...
So what you're saying essentially
no, it
is
goes over this one.
A cat's tail hears no outside noises,
no.
Only the ones directed at it.
See, have you ever heard a cat fart? It does. That's why you never hear a cat fart, because they have a tail like that. All right.
Okay.
Now the next part.
The SteadyCam.
This I saw on the internet. I'll give you its site.
Okay.
Give you the site. But I wanted some shots. I was thinking of doing something with the dogs, and I wanted to be able to videotape them down at their level and kind of follow them for a walk. And I did some, so I'll show you that video I did. But let me show you. This is me. I made this from an internet site. I typed in SteadyCam, but I'll give you that internet site. It says for $19 or $18 you can create this. However, it cost me $26 by the time I was all done. And let me show you how it works. It's just galvanized pipe. It screws into here like this. It's threaded. This is 10 inch. It's got this little T right here. T. And then this is a weight I got at Walmart for $2.50, I think, or $3. It's a 2.5 pound weight, which is heavy with the second. And this gives you some balance. So let me take this apart and show you how it works. This I made also. I twisted that myself with my little workshop. The camera goes on here like this. And hold it there. It's got a way to do it. Here, I got it. And then you can steady it. You can hold this because of the weight. And you hold it like this, and then you can take pictures. And you can go up or down, and it'll really hold it steady. Even though this has an image stabilizer, it really holds it steady.
You're actually hooking into that, though, right?
Well, no, that's the first way to do it without that.
Yeah.
Now what you can do is then you can make this, and I'll do some close-ups on it. But you make this, you put this on here, and then you basically put the camera on it like this. And now you can put it down. I'm just going to let you, I'll show you some. And hold it like this. And basically down at the level of the dogs, you can follow the dogs around and make some really smooth moves. Or you can put it the other way and you can get up high. I did some videos of Gene washing the car and I had it really high. And so you can look down. And the only other thing I added onto it is that one. If you want to make it a little longer, you can put a longer one on it so you can be way down to the ground or you can be way up high. So this little SteadyCam is really nice.
Yeah, so you'll be able to see the difference between the SteadyCam and then without it. Right?
Yeah, and... Now I'm going to go do some cutaways, and I'm also going to show you the difference between the regular microphone and the shotgun mic. Right now, for this part where we're standing like this, anytime you hear it will be the eyesight built-in mic. but now I'm gonna hook up the camera and do some things with the camera.
What am I doing?
You're making sounds.
Making sounds?
So just say something, talk, speak.
Once upon a midnight dreary, as I pondered weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, suddenly I heard a tapping, as of someone gently rapping, rapping at my chamber door.
Oh, that's really good. Okay, I'm going to want you to do that again now with the other. Would you do that more often?
That's the raven.
I know, I like that.
Yeah, that's one of my favorite poems.
Do you know any more? Is that all you know of that one?
Yeah, I know it if I could see it.
Well, maybe you could do that again, just like that, because that sort of is cool. Okay, now I am about to plug in the microphone. And now the shotgun mic is plugged in, so the sound should have changed a little, I hope. So now you want to repeat that again? And I'm about the same distance as the eyesight was.
Okay. Once upon a midnight dreary, as I pondered weak and weary, over many a quaint and curious volume of forgotten lore, suddenly I heard a tapping, as of someone gently rapping at my chamber door.
Wow. I'm trying to zoom. That's cool. Oops.
You're zooming?
Your face is like perfect. I think it's the greatest white beard out there. Okay. Was that good?
That was good.
That was good. It was only like, what, 30 minutes long or something?
It seemed like that.
And he was so nice. He was so nice to do this with me.
Oh, yeah.
Well, what?
Oh, yeah.
Wait,
let me take this off here before it hurts the camera.
Good idea.